The Philippines logged 1,591 new COVID-19 cases Wednesday, the lowest single-day tally since February 24. Seven laboratories were not able to submit data. The number of active cases now down to 38,000. Based on projections from the health department, active cases in the Philippines may decrease to 14,909 by mid-November if the current health system capacity and vaccination is maintained, together with 82% mobility. This number may decrease even further by mid-December. But should the country's health system capacity worsen and increased mobility lead to violations of health protocols, by December 15, active cases could go the opposite direction.
Kung ang ating pagiging mas mobile ay sasabayan ng pagbaba ng ating adherence to minimum public health standards at babagal na naman ang paghahanap at pag-isolate natin ng kaso, from just 2,100, posibleng umakyat ang mga active cases natin to 49 to 52,000.
Health Secretary Francisco Duque stresses that aside from vaccination, adherence to minimum public health standards remains important.
If we are careful, if we don't squander the gains that we have achieved so far, if we continue to do this with consistency or with cadence, I think we will be able to bring it down to even below 2,000 cases a day.
He adds, instead of becoming complacent as cases decline, local government units should preserve the gains by ramping up their COVID-19 response.
Importante ay they're able to do this so that the containment measures are successful and reflected by the fact that the cases are going down. Consistency. That this is the time to do mopping up operations. They should exert all effort to identify sources of infection.
Based on figures from Our World in Data, Thailand, Singapore, and Laos now have higher positivity rates than the Philippines. It can be recalled that these countries logged lower numbers than the Philippines several months ago. Duque says the number of people getting tested for COVID-19 has gone downward by 11.5% as the positivity rate improves.
Pagsapit ng Kapaskuhan, gusto natin maging masaya ang ating pagdiriwang na may magandang COVID-19 situation sa pagtatapos ng ating taon. At pagsisikapan natin lahat na mapanatili ang pagbaba ng ating mga kaso hanggang sa susunod na taon.
Rafael Bosano, ABS-CBN News.